So, having looked at some of these, capabilities of Sunbird, enabled through by various building blocks, let's look at some examples of, some reference apps that have been made and been utilized, just to see, how some of these come into action, how they can be utilized by adopters, and for which I would request Namrata to walk us through that. Namrata, your slides are visible.
Thanks, Salil.
Yes. Go ahead.
Okay, so the end learner, whether it's a school student, whether it's a teacher, a health worker, or a farmer, eventually accesses learning assets and the power of these Sunbird capabilities that you've been hearing about today through an app, right? So in this session, I'm going to talk about the various reference apps that Sunbird provides. As we go through this, do imagine how your organization can leverage these apps to solve your specific needs. So the building blocks that you've heard about today, right, whether they are digital assets, asset players, content discovery mechanisms like QR scan, search, interaction tools, etc., they're all stitched together into these three reference apps: the mobile app, the desktop app, and the web application. And it's these apps that help create meaningful learning experiences. The reference apps that I'm talking to you today are customized for the education domain. So each of these three apps solve very specific use cases. The mobile app, for example, enables access to learning assets on the go. It is the best medium for learning by oneself, in addition to allowing for greater personalization and offline support. And I'll talk a little bit about offline support in a little bit. The web application gives you the flexibility of accessing learning assets without having to download an app. Since a web application runs on various types of devices, whether it's a mobile, a PC, a tablet, or even a smart TV, it allows for, of course, self-learning, but also for a classroom-type learning experience, right? Like a broadcast teaching type experience. The desktop app, on the other hand, has a unique value proposition on top of this. So it allows you to access learning assets on an under-leveraged and older computer as well. So apart from catering to the latest types of PCs that are available, it also helps you access on older, like Linux and Windows versions as well. So in doing so, it unlocks a host of use cases around peer-to-peer learning. So imagine like learners huddled together around a computer to learn. And of course, also allows for the other two types of use cases, which is classroom-based teaching by attaching it to a projector or a TV, and self-learning, of course. So the reference apps have been designed keeping the diversity of typical learning environments in mind, whether it is the diversity of internet access or access to devices or even other resources in general, right? And I'll talk about just three capabilities today that empower learning in these diverse environments. The first and arguably the most important one is the ability to learn both online and offline. So throughout most of the world, there are pockets of areas that have limited to no internet access. So how do we make sure that learners in those areas which are primarily disconnected still get access to the same types of learning opportunities? So Sunbird addresses this by providing capabilities to download and play content offline. So any user can download content when they have access to internet, download the content and play it offline. But in addition to this, it also allows for physical distribution of the content for pure offline scenarios. So picture a user downloading content where there is internet, writing it to an SD card or a pen drive and physically transporting that pen drive to a place where there is no internet, right? And in that isolated area, the learner can install the application, can play that content purely offline. In addition to this, it also allows access to usage data. So imagine that that device that was purely offline now emits usage data when it comes online, right? If it intermittently has access. Or imagine that someone can extract that data out using, again, a pen drive or an SD card and physically moves it to a place where there is internet so that usage data can get looked at, right? Giving this gives us valuable insights about both content usage as well as learning needs. And as you've heard about before, that's a critical part of gauging the effectiveness of a solution. So some use cases around offline and online usage that adopters have either implemented or imagined till date, and you can use this to imagine what works for your needs, right? So one was an organization looked at leveraging the commute time in buses in order to allow their employees to upskill themselves. So they created a local network where courses were hosted on a device, and employees could download those courses using their mobile phone purely offline and could play those courses during that commute time. Another scenario is one where coaching centers can conduct mock exams for students in a purely offline manner using like computers that are present on premise. Another example is imagine a community shop or a community center which acts as a content distribution hub and can distribute SD cards or pen drives with content provided, thus making sure that content can reach the last mile, right? And provide access in the most isolated areas. The second critical capability is localization. So localization is a critical part of the learning experience. In addition to content being multilingual, Sunbird also allows for, or these reference apps interfaces are built multilingual first, which means that a learner can navigate their interface in the language that they understand. And these interfaces also provide support for languages that are meant to be read right to left, like Urdu, for example. The third critical capability is that of multi-user access. So in a country like India, there are many scenarios where there's only one household in a household or a group of households, right? Which need to be shared between students to learn. Or they may be like an NGO which is going to work with farmers in a field, but maybe they only have one or two tablets with them. And all the farmers have to come together and learn off of these one or two devices, right? So the capability here allows for multiple users to create profiles on the same device. And each of these users can switch between the profiles. So each profile contains the learning history of the user, so they can pick up from where they last left off. So considering all of what you've heard today, what can you do next, right? So you can use the reference apps exactly as is. So you can just pick up and get started with that. And like I mentioned earlier, it is customized to the education domain. You can choose to customize the reference apps, meaning that you can either pick and choose parts of the workflows that make sense for you, or maybe you take the entire thing, but just customize the UI or the look and feel of that reference app. Or the third thing you can do is build your own app from scratch using the building blocks you've heard about earlier as part of the earlier sessions.
Yeah. Okay.
Over to you, Salim.
Yes, right. Thank you, Namita. See if I can just pull in Rahul back again. Rahul, there was a question on the registries bit as well. Is there any example of Sunbird's registry being used specifically anywhere, and how exactly is it benefiting the users?
Right. Yeah. So there is a very topical example given the situation today. I guess most of you would have either used the Cowin application already or will use it sometime in the near future. The backend for Cowin is OpenSaber. It uses the Sunbird registry framework. So there are multiple aspects to it, right? There are details of hospitals or vaccination service providers where users can go book an appointment and get their vaccinations done. There are certificates that the end users get in terms of who has been vaccinated and who has not. These again, run off a registry. The idea is different sets of users get different views into this data. So as an end user, I might only want to know what are the centers where appointments are available. As a vaccinator, I might want to know what are the facilities available at the vaccination center and what sort of vaccines are being handed out. Or as somebody from the government representative, I might want to have a single source of truth that I can go to understand what percentage of the population has been vaccinated, right? So all these data points coming off a single source of truth is very key in a large scale drive like this. If every center were to maintain their own database, it would be next to impossible to try and compare each time to figure out whether somebody has been vaccinated or not.
Indeed.
So a single source of truth for all systems to talk to is what we have enabled for Cowen using the OpenSaver architecture.
Okay, thank you, Rahul. I think an extremely, relatable and very, very relevant example, especially in current times.